Welcome to the 2020 graduation ceremony for Central Florida Christian Academy. My name is Adam Matthews, and I am the student government chaplain. I welcome parents, grandparents, friends, and family of our graduates and CFCA. Allow me to open this evening in prayer. Let's bow our heads. God, I thank you for the opportunity for all of us to gather here today. I pray that this evening's ceremony will honor you as well as us honoring the graduates. I know that these are weird times, but you are in control of it all. I pray that tonight the graduates will feel encouraged and go out from here with a heart ready to face the world with you at the center of their lives. We owe all our success to you, and thank you for it. I pray all of these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
You may be seated. Thank you, Adam. Central Florida Christian Academy graduation is a worship service. Tonight, we will be honoring our seniors, and we ask that in respect and honor to our seniors, that you honor with applause rather than loud noises, screams, or artificial noisemakers. Thank you for allowing us to honor our seniors in this manner. I can't believe we're here. We've prayed about this. We've wondered. We've thought. I just want to say thank you for your patience and your kindness as we planned this graduation this evening. It's going to look a little different, but it's going to have a lot of the same aspects that we've always had in our CFCA graduations. At this time, I would like to introduce to you those on the platform. I am Pam Theobald. I am the principal at Central Florida Christian Academy. We also have Mrs. Christy LaViolette, our upper school coordinator and English teacher, Mr. Kyle Wills, our athletic director, Mr. Jeremy Campbell, our dean of students, Dr. Hal Stewart, our CFCA headmaster, and Dr. Clayton Clower, senior pastor, Church of the Cross, and CFCA president. At this time, I would like to invite Bradley Van Dam, Class of 2020 President, to the platform.
Well, we did it. Senior class of 2020, we have accomplished something spectacular. Graduation is one of the most meaningful moments in all of our high school careers, and not only have we achieved success, but we have prevailed victorious despite the challenges we as a class have experienced throughout these past 4 years of our life. Most notably, the biggest obstacle that we as seniors have had to overcome within these past 2 months is quite obvious. With the increasing threat of COVID-19 throughout the world, every class of 2020, unfortunately, has had their glorious last few months of senior year stripped from them. We have been quarantined to our homes and forced to finish out this year alone. What our class has been through is like no other. Having Zoom calls with our teachers and having to learn in entirely different ways has by all means pushed us as students and as young men and women. But above all, we have adapted, we persevered, and we succeeded. For many, this may not be the closure that we expected. The best year of high school was cut short. We missed out on a lot. Our senior prom, grad bash, being able to irritate the teachers that in only a couple months we would be able to call them by their first names without getting demerits, and most importantly, being able to have a regular graduation. Though these circumstances may weigh down our hearts with sadness, it is important to look above the horizon, past our hardships, and put our faith in God's omniscient plan for all of our lives. This idea of committing to God's plan can best be seen in Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. God knows what's right for our lives, and he has paved a path for all of us to follow. While this path may present its fair share of challenges, we must stay on track and not veer away from its course because God's presence comes with safety. Besides the unusual circumstance that we're in right now, I think I can speak for the entire class that we are very ready to just be done with this year. I know all of us could benefit from sleeping in a little more, and parents, it's okay for us to sleep until 3:30 in the afternoon. We'll be fine, we're young. This class has been together for a long time now. Our senior class has become the closest-knit group of students that I have personally ever seen. I am overwhelmed beyond words as to how lucky I am to have spent my life with you guys. Some of you I have known for practically my entire life, and others I have only known for a couple, but yet the connection we all have feels the same. I consider each one of you guys family. We've had such good memories together. Whether they be from absolutely dominating the competition and homecoming challenges from previous years, shout out to Ms. Matthews and Mr. Theobald, you guys are legends. The past homecoming dances we have gotten to enjoy, our senior trip and going whitewater rafting, listening to the really weird safety instructor tell us that if we were to somehow get stuck underneath the whitewater raft, which already freaked us all out, that we would need to Spider-Man crawl our way to the surface, and if we did not do so, we would turn our 12-foot raft into a 60-foot yacht. For all the seniors, you know what I'm talking about. Or the hilarious moments in AP Gov when Josh Ciudad would constantly ask Mr. Theobald questions to stall for class time. Sitting in marine science, watching random documentaries, trying our absolute hardest not to fall asleep. And Jared going into the middle school hallway and roasting all the middle schoolers for being so lame. The multiple mini-messer trips that we went on resulting in hundreds of inside jokes. The constant shenanigans and dumb things that we would do in the cafeteria during lunchtime that nearly brought us all to tears from laughing too hard. Debating over the stupidest stuff in several different classes because both the teachers and us students were bored of being productive, or having our annual end of the year pool party at your boy's house. I could stand up here for hours on end telling you about all the good memories we've made together, but we are running on a time budget and I wouldn't want to bore all of you. To wrap things up, our future is looking pretty bright, seniors. We will be able to take our strengths that we have developed over the past few years and apply them to our lives. We are adaptable, resourceful, imaginative, social, emotional, different, and most of all, we are more than capable of whatever life has to throw our way. Thank you. I would also like to announce the class gift. The class of 2020 is pleased to present to CFCA an AccuCut Mark V die cut machine with a new set of upper and lower case alphabet letters and numbers, as well as several additional dies and storage racks. We hope this will prove very useful for every teacher and staff member at CFCA as a tool to assist you with bulletin board preparation, special projects, curricular enhancement, and classroom decoration. Thank you.
Seniors, it is tradition at CFCA for each senior to receive a coin before graduation. We have placed three coins under your chair this evening. The first coin is for you to keep to remind you to pray for your classmates as you embark on separate journeys. The second coin is for you to give to your parents so that when they see it, they will continue to pray for you. And the third coin is for you to give to someone that is invested in your life through prayer and guidance. This coin serves as a reminder of the love and sacrifice that many have made for you to finish this race.
Now it is time to give the Daniel and Esther Award. These are our Christian Character Awards. They are the most prestigious honor given at Central Florida Christian Academy in recognition of a student whose godly character is truly exceptional. Students should exemplify the godly character that we strive for at CFCA, along with initiative, effort, and academic excellence. As Daniel and Esther, we are seeking to reward students for going into a foreign land and being a testimony for Christ. A key character trait of the student receiving the Daniel and Esther Award should be service before self. We use Colossians 1:10 to base this on, so that you may walk in a manner worthy of the Lord to please him in all respects, bearing fruit in every good work and increasing in knowledge of God. Our Class of 2020 Daniel Award goes to Adam Matthews. The Class of 2020 ESTER Award winner is Bo Verkorti. Round of applause for them one more time. It is my honor tonight to tell you that the Class of 2020 at Central Florida Christian Academy has earned academic, athletic, and leadership scholarships totaling over $2.5 million, and money is still coming in. Amen. We are so thankful for the provision that God has given to each of our seniors, and we know that He has and will continue to guide their steps. What students need to succeed in the 21st century is an education that is both academically rigorous and real-world relevant. Those being a given, it is up to the students themselves to accept the responsibility of availing themselves of all that the school has to offer. The students whom I am introducing this evening have done just that. They've worked diligently to achieve and have gone above and beyond the norm. It is my privilege to introduce to you the salutatorian and the valedictorian of Central Florida Christian Academy's Class of 2020. The Class of 2020 salutatorian is Adam Lane Matthews. He will come and give his speech, and after his speech, we will hear from the Class of 2020 valedictorian, Brandon Lam Nguyen.
Welcome, graduating Class of 2020. Welcome, parents, family, teachers, and friends. Welcome to all those watching at home. We wish you could be here. The first people I want to address are all of the AP Lang students. I wanted to let you know that Ms. LaViolette expects a rhetorical analysis of this speech, so get your pens and paper ready. I would like to congratulate my fellow classmates on being the senior skip day champions of the century. The last quarter of school literally zoomed by. Parents, you may want to also put aside a little money for future therapy, because there are a few phrases that may eventually trigger some PTSD for us. Phrases such as social distancing, 6 feet apart, face masks, and toilet paper. Oh, and although it used to be simply making us think of a beloved Disney film from our childhood, the phrase, "We're all in this together," is now a little more panic-inducing than watching High School Musical. I joined CFCA at an interesting time in my life. After 6.5 years in Texas, we moved back to Florida halfway through my eighth grade year, and I obviously did not really know anyone. I panicked a little at the thought of introducing myself to a bunch of students who already knew each other and had established friend groups. I remembered going to school for the first day in January and having my mom as my first period teacher. That was not too weird for me because she had been my teacher since I was in fifth grade. The strange thing was she was no longer my choir director. Instead, she was my Spanish teacher. She didn't know a lick of Spanish. I walked into her room where I didn't know any of the students. And who did I sit next to? Bullcut Bradley. He was a better friend than fashion icon. And somehow, one day at a time, I got to know my classmates, and they got to know me. They welcomed me and the rest of my family in a way that made our transition to CFCA quite easy. The friends I made that first semester have stuck with me, and I am so grateful for that. I want to thank all of you for being there for me. I love you guys. We have shared many experiences together, from wild Xbox parties with the boys, Culver's runs, class pool parties, sporting events, memes, and the adventures of senior trip, and the emotional separation due to COVID-19. Even though we have missed out on a lot of things like prom, grad bash, and even a normal graduation, we have gotten through it together. But we definitely can't say that we've gotten through it alone. Teachers. We all owe you a huge thank you for loving and encouraging us, your students, and for putting in countless hours to prepare lessons, send emails, grade assignments, and offer help classes. I have witnessed this at home with my mom, who has worked so hard to try and make learning fun for her students. And teachers, even when you get mad at us, you still have the patience to deal with our ridiculousness. I want to specifically thank Mr. Theobald and Ms. Matthews, aka my mom, the sponsors of the senior class, for going above and beyond to make our high school experience fun. You planned events, organized snack shop, put together senior trip, and helped with all the amazing homecoming festivities. Your dedication has made our high school experience more enjoyable. I want to give a short shout out to my two older brothers, Jake, who is watching from home in Virginia, and Lincoln, for sharing life with me and being there when I needed someone. A Bible verse that comes to mind was Proverbs 17:17. A friend loves at all times, and a brother is born for times of adversity. They have always supported me from sporting events to academics. I have been so grateful to have grown up with you guys, and even though we would fight, we would always forgive each other. I love you guys, and I could not have asked for better brothers. I also want to thank the rest of my family. My grandparents have never doubted me and have always told me that I could do it. I have been so grateful for the childhood that they have given me, loving me every moment of it. My cousins for being awesome and making life more fun. I last of all want to thank my mom and dad. I have never spent more than a week away from both of my parents, and I'm not sure how I feel about moving out. I have never been at a school where my parents did not teach, and I am not sure how I feel about that either. To say the least, my parents have been there for me and with me every step of the way. They have helped me through late night math homework that had me crying in the 7th and first part of 8th grade. I feel that I also cannot talk about my parents without talking about a specific moment with my mom. I know this may make me sound like a baby, but in the 3rd grade, I had to read Charlotte's Web, and when we finished the book, my mom and I both started crying. She told me it was one of her favorite memories with me, so I thought I'd bring it up just to make her cry some more. To my dad, I have been so grateful to share so many fantastic memories with you, like the 3GT, aka 3 Generations Tour, and other adventures that we have made. Most importantly, I want to thank both of you for teaching me to live for Christ. I have been so blessed to have parents that taught me how to live according to God's word. I love you guys. I would most of all like to thank God for guiding me through my life. His daily presence is so important. From the day I was born, God's love has been apparent to me. He has blessed me with amazing friends and family who love me and support me through all that I do, and who love me enough to call me out when I'm off base. I have never doubted that I belong here. I would like to offer some advice for those not yet finished with their high school experience. The biggest advantages you can give yourself are: listen instead of talk, do what is requested of you without complaining, at least to the teacher, and respect your teachers, coaches, and administrators, and they will offer you respect in return. These practices have helped me beyond belief. I believe in each and every one of my classmates. You're about to face the world, but I implore you to stay strong, not only mentally, but spiritually. God has a plan for your life. A quote from C.S. Lewis says, "It is not your business to succeed, but to do right. When you have done so, the rest lies with God. Follow his guidance by reading his word and praying, and you will go far." Thank you.
Dear Brother Clayton, Dr. Stewart, administration, faculty, staff, senior class, family, and friends. Today I stand here amongst many friends, family, teachers, and school administrators who have throughout the years supported me and my fellow peers during our time in high school, and most importantly, during these final moments of our senior year, which, if you haven't noticed, been completely thrown off the rails. But I'm not here to talk about how our class could not have a final prom night. I am not here to talk about how we can't have all of our family here to share in the joy of seeing the culmination of our work for the past 4 years. No. I am here to talk about how we stand here today, even in the haze of the situation we are enveloped in, ready to step to the next phase of our lives. I am here to talk about how every person in this room, and not only my fellow soon-to-be graduates, have persisted and put forth all their efforts for a chance to be here today. For that, I have a couple people to thank. I would like to thank all the school administrators, Mrs. Theobald, Ms. Foss, Coach Campbell, Mr. Wills, Pastor Howell, and Pastor Clower, for working tirelessly to give our senior class the best graduation experience possible. I would like to thank our class sponsors, Mr. Theobald and Mrs. Matthews, who have been personally supporting each and every one of us, each and every step of the way throughout high school. From the moment we enrolled to be part of CFCA's class of 2020, into our digital farewells and good lucks on Zoom. To my dearest friends, both those graduating with me today and those who have already moved on to the next level, thank you for all the experiences and memories that we have had together. All of the times that we have laughed and cried and struggled and celebrated all together. A keystone memory of our senior class that I personally will never forget is the time during our senior trip that we went around discussing how we all met, what we liked most about each other, and also, but maybe not explicitly, what kept us together. Obviously, we're held together by our grade level, but throughout the years, it has become much more than that. Proverbs 27:17 says that iron sharpens iron, and one man sharpens another. From all the friendships that I have developed with you, and all the bonds that you have with each other, I can see that we have become the essence of this proverb, and I would not rather want to graduate with any other group of friends than with you all. To my teachers, including but not limited to Mr. McClintock, Mr. Theobald, Mr. Barker, Mr. Harkula, Mrs. Matthews, Ms. Selman, and Mrs. LaViolette, thank you for always pushing me to my limits, aiding me in my academic endeavors, and being a positive impact on my faith. For every misconception that I've had about AP Chemistry, an extremely difficult course, every incomplete timed right, every forgotten negative sign, and every off-key note that I've sung in your classes, you have taught me that mistakes are okay, and that the drive to persist is what really matters. And this leads me to my family. My grandpa, which in Vietnamese is translated Ong Wai, was a prisoner of war during the Vietnam War. After the war had ended, my grandpa was given access to residency in the United States, and therefore my parents and family were also able to move over. Moving from Vietnam and being brought up in a drastically different culture and into the United States proved to be challenging in many ways for them. Although my family knew little English in migrating to the United States, they still fought to survive amid their new home. My aunts, Nguyen, Minh Thu, and my uncle Chau, labored to build up a nail salon while my mom and dad worked at a hair cuttery for several years before opening their own small business as well. They worked with what little they had and had a vision to make a better living for themselves and ultimately to provide for me, my brother, and cousins so that we could have a better future than we would have in Vietnam. As I was born in the U.S., there was always a clash between my Vietnamese background and my American nationality, both of which I hold strong to my identity. But without a doubt, Mom and Dad, you have been the greatest inspiration to me in all my life. Knowing where you came from, what you started with, and how you work endlessly to provide for my brother and I is the drive for my perseverance in school and in all things. I will not let this opportunity for success that you have sacrificed so much to bring about go to waste. To my extended family, I know that this is a troubling time for all of us, especially with the passing of Yu Yan. But I know that we will make it through this because you have already made known to me and the world that we are a family of strength. Today I stand knowing I have a legacy to carry on the torch, the fire, that my family has passed down onto me. However, I believe that the spirit of resolve resides in all of us. In some it lies dormant, waiting to be ignited. In others, it burns with passion and shines bright for all to see. So to my fellow soon-to-be graduates, I ask, what is your vision? There is no resolve without a resolution or an end in sight. I encourage you to look at what is next. Times will get difficult, and your motivation will be snapped in an instant. And many of the times, you will have absolutely no control of it. However, the choice lies with you, whether you get back up or you let your dreams die right there. It is in these moments where you can choose to cling to your ambitions or to give them up and leave your efforts for naught. Thomas Edison puts things into perspective very well. When a reporter asked him how it felt to fail 1,000 times in creating the light bulb, he responded, "I didn't fail 1,000 times. The light bulb was an invention of 1,000 steps." Therefore, my friends, I encourage you as we celebrate these final moments of high school to realize what drives you to continue on from here and to persevere through whatever challenge may come. Thank you.
At this time, we're going to give out the Old Eagle Awards. This award goes to students who've been at CFCA since kindergarten or longer. We want to honor the students and their families' loyalty, dedication, and perseverance at Central Florida Christian Academy. So when I call your name, please walk to the stage and receive your award. And when you get up here, please remain because we'll take a picture. Miles Bruton, 16 years. Jared Furtado, 14 years. Haley Morgan, 13 years. Parker Theobald, 18 years. Jalen Underwood, 14 years. And Bradley Van Dam, 16 years. This year, we also have a second-generation graduate. And so this recognition goes to families that have a first and second generation of graduates from Central Florida Christian Academy. Will Mr. Theobald please join his son at the platform at this time? Mr. David Theobald, the first generation, is from the class of 1994. His son, Parker Theobald, the second generation, is graduating tonight. We would like to present these framed senior pictures to Mr. Theobald and Parker. Ladies and gentlemen, please recognize the first and second generation Theobald family.
Well, these moments are always very emotional for me because I feel like each one of these young people and each one of you are a part of our family. The Church at the Cross and Central Florida Christian Academy takes the privilege that you give us incredibly serious. And we know that you have vested enormous trust and confidence in us to enroll your children in this school and to give us the opportunity to educate and inspire and equip them. And when you hang around here as long as I have now, this is my 16th graduating class since I've been the pastor, and I've known all of these old eagles since they were in the preschool and have watched them grow up each step of the way. And so I want to say a thank you to all of the parents and family members who have sacrificed to put your children here, to be taught and raised here. We have been humbled by it, and we thank you for the opportunity to be a part of your family. We also want to say a special word of thanks to all of our faculty for the just incredible commitment they have made to not only be academically qualified to teach in their field, but then spiritually passionate and a lover of students and willing to invest themselves each day in the lives of young people. That's not an easy task. And plus, they've done it in a private Christian school where they've taken less money than they would have received in another context, but they've done it because they believe, they have a conviction that the opportunity to train your children and to be trusted by you to educate, inspire, and equip them has a value that will last beyond this sphere in this world. So thank you, faculty, Dr. Stewart, Ms. Theobald, all of the leaders of our school. The Church of the Cross is extremely proud to have Central Florida Christian Academy as one of its largest ministries. And I also want to just cherish this moment to speak to these graduates, as in just a moment we'll confer degrees upon you, and you will scatter out like seed across the world. And just in these few moments, these last moments, I want to take the opportunity to say something to you. I feel like something needs to be said, not because of maybe what's deficient in you. That's not it at all. We marvel at the giftedness, the commitment, the collective wisdom, the heart of this group. And we have seen it over these last 77 days in an amazing way, as you have rallied and you have completed your senior year in a time that, of course, is unprecedented in our history as a nation or even as a civilization. It's amazing what you've done, and you've been an inspiration to all of us. And so I say these words not because we think, hey, you better hear these because you're going to mess it up out there. No, we look forward to what you are going to do. We're not waiting for you to be leaders. You're already leaders. And we look forward to the way you're going to put your hands on this world and make it a better nation and a better world in which to live. But just from our Lord Jesus, I'm mindful of what God would say to us tonight. And I want to read just one verse of Scripture to you out of Ephesians chapter 5. The Scripture says, "Look carefully then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise, making the best use of your time, because the days are evil." I do want to say something from the future to you, because many of us, we've lived a few more years than you have, and there's some experiences we have. So I want to give you three things just to remember as you go from this place, from this community. The first thing I would say to you is give praise to God. Every day is a blessing from Almighty God. You are not promised tomorrow. The Bible says, do not boast of tomorrow. You don't know what a day may bring forth. And certainly we have learned that in the last 77 days, that we all presumed we would have all of these events that we planned, and there was a different future for each one of us. The Bible says in Psalm 145 in verse 2 that every day I will bless you and praise your name. So take every day and seize the opportunity to praise God. Your relationship with God's the most important relationship you have in your life, and every day is a gift. That which separates you from a practical atheist is that you would see each day as a gift from Almighty God, and your life as a blessing from Him. And so I pray and I beg you to see each day as a gift and praise God each day. but also realize that every day has a promise. The Bible says if you will draw near to God, He will draw near to you. God loves you and has given more for you than anyone else in your life, including even your parents, your siblings, your peers, even these teachers. The Bible says that God so loved you that He gave His only Son to die for you upon the cross. And God took upon flesh and walked among us, and when He died to pay for your sin, to die for you, to reconcile you to God. So take every day, give praise to God. Let me tell you secondly, every day, work hard. Get up and go to work. Find something that you want to do and do it with all your heart. The Bible says that everything you do, do in the name of the Lord Jesus. Every day matters. And so go seize the day to put the work in. Do the little things well. Don't look for shortcuts. Put the time in that it takes. You will fail, as Brandon spoke to us just a moment ago. Life is really about how you progress from failure. If you think that people who are successful are always successful, you have romanticized success and really have no concept of what it takes to get anywhere. It takes a lot of failure. It takes a lot of struggle. Every day will bring unexpected challenges and setbacks. It will not be easy. There will be ups and downs, and it will be scary at times. I'm reminded of the story of Joseph and how he went through each one of these setbacks, and yet he tenaciously pursued a life that would honor God. Stay close to God. Give Him praise every day. Work hard. And then thirdly, enjoy your life. The Bible says if you would love life and see good days, do what the text says, to look carefully how you live, not as unwise but as wise. Make the best use of your time. The days really are evil. Enjoy your life. Build some relationships. You have invested in relationships here. And maybe one of the greatest things that you've experienced on this campus, it may not be learning calculus or chemistry. It may end up being relationships. You have learned much about that with one another in all of the diversity and complexity that you have as a class. Learn to laugh every day. Think every day. Enjoy your life. God wants you to enjoy the life that you have. In Psalm 126, the Bible says, "Blessed is the man, the woman who fears the Lord. And when they do well, and they are blessed, they will enjoy it. They will be happy." And so go enjoy your life. Praise God every day for what you have. Put the work in and enjoy your life. Live it to the fullest for the Lord Jesus Christ. For He is worthy. He is worthy for you. And it could be you haven't crossed that line of faith yet. You still have yet to make that decision to believe. Tonight could be that night for you, friend. The scripture says that God is not far from any one of us. In fact, the scripture says that He is near to all of us. And that when we speak of Him, of His love, His attributes, of His Son's death upon the cross, that He is especially close to us. He's in our mouth and He's in our heart through the words that we say. The holy writings say that God knocks at the door of your heart. God will not force His love upon anyone. Forced love is not love. God extends His love to you. And that while you have broken God's law, and we all have sinned, we are all flawed, God gave His Son to die for you. And now his love attracts you. His love compels you. His love calls you. You want to really live life to the fullest? Give your life to Christ tonight. And leave here praising God every day, putting in the work. Do the work that it takes and enjoy your life. Father, thank you for the class of 2020. Thank you for the way that they have led our school this year. It has been beautiful. It has been healthy. Thank you for the example they have been. Thank you for the way that they've challenged things. They've interacted with the teaching and the instruction. They've been blessed to hear so much, and they have given much. Now, Lord, we pray the favor and blessing of God upon them as they leave this place and scatter around the world. May they be blessed as they go out. May they be blessed as they come in. May they enjoy their life. May they give praise to God, and may they put the work in. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good evening. Seniors, please come forward with your parents when I call your name for the presentation of diplomas. As I read, please know that the character traits mentioned for each senior were selected by their teachers. The first senior is Alejandro Bernal. Alejandro's not here this evening. We are going to spend a minute reading his paragraph. Alejandro is the son of Ricardo Bernal and Jeanette Torres Cruz. He has attended CFCA for 4 years. His character trait is alertness, being aware of that which is taking place around me so that I can have the right response to them. Alejandro's wit and reason set him apart in his interactions. His awareness of those around him give him the ability to participate in many conversations with ease. Upon graduating, Alejandro will attend the University of Central Florida and study senior living management. Alejandro Bernal. Virikwartai Bo. Virikwartai Bo. Bo is the daughter of Chan Sambo and Kay Sapheap. She has attended CFCA for 1 year. Her character trait is love, giving to others basic needs without having as my motive personal reward. Bo is a sweet and gentle young woman who goes out of her way to make those around her feel comfortable. Her hard work is evident not only in her schoolwork, but in the friendships that she builds as well. After graduation, Bo plans to attend Daytona State College and major in business management. Virikwartai Bo. Miles Omari Xavier Bruton. Miles Omari Xavier Bruton. Miles is the son of Philip Bruton and Mary Cotman. He has attended CFCA for 16 years and is an Old Eagle recipient. His character trait is deference, limiting my freedom in order not to offend the tastes of those God has called me to serve. Miles is a humble and caring guy who is willing to put himself aside for the feelings and concerns of his friends. He leads by example and also makes his classmates laugh with his quick sense of humor. Upon graduating, Miles plans to attend Valencia College and study forensic science. Miles Omari Xavier Bruton. Mm-hmm. Caillou Charles Denise Farias. Caillou is the son of Elsian Farias and Patricia Denise. He has attended CFCA for 1 year. His character trait is patience, accepting a difficult situation from God without giving him a deadline to remove it. Caillou has worked hard to overcome his language barrier by being kind and asking for help whenever he needs it. Upon graduating, Caillou will attend Valencia College and study forensic odontology. Caillou Charles Denise Farias. Gabrielle Albuquerque Santos Costa. Gabrielle Albuquerque Santos Costa. Gabby is the daughter of Aldo and Enya Costa. She has attended CFCA for 6 years. Her character trait is gentleness, showing personal care and concern in meeting the needs of others. Gabby's smile lights up any room she enters, and she loves spending time with her classmates. She is a faithful friend and a shoulder to cry on. Gabby plans to attend University of South Florida and study dance and performing arts. Gabrielle Albuquerque Santos Costa. Larry Jeremiah Forrest. Larry Jeremiah Forrest. Larry is the son of Larry and Lakeitha Forrest. He has attended CFCA for 6 years. His character trait is reverence, awareness of how God is working through the people and events in my life to produce the character of Christ in me. Larry's determination and respect for his teachers and peers sets him apart from others. His drive to pursue his passions will lead him to future success. Larry plans to attend Advent Health University and study nursing. Larry Jeremiah Forrest. Jared David Furtado. Jared David Furtado. Jared is the son of David and Deanna Furtado. He has attended CFCA for 14 years and is an Old Eagle recipient. His character trait is boldness, confidence that what I have to say or do is true and right and just in the sight of God. Jared is not afraid to be the life of the party or the classroom and is willing to put aside what others think in order to display truth in any conversation. Jared plans to attend Lake Technical College and study automotive technology. Jared David Furtado. Mikhail Joseph Hernandez. Mikhail Joseph Hernandez. Mikhail is the son of Michelle Rodriguez. He has attended CFCA for 7 years. His character trait is meekness, yielding my personal rights and expectations to God. Mikhail's fun and lighthearted personality is a staple of the class of 2020. His capacity to go with the flow helps him make the best out of every situation. Upon graduation, Mikhail plans to attend Valencia College and study pre-medicine. Mikhail Yosef Hernandez. Alicia Shantoria Holly. Alicia Shantoria Holly. Lisa is the daughter of Stacy and Natasha Holly. She has attended CFCA for 4 years. Her character trait is justice, personal responsibility to God's unchanging laws. Lisa is a bright spot in the day of CFCA. She may be small, but her smile is giant. She stands up for what she believes in and doesn't back down. Lisa will attend Jacksonville University and study neonatal nursing. Alicia Shantoria Holly. Griffin Daniel Horn. Griffin Daniel Horn. Griffin is the son of Dan and Leslie Horn. He has attended CFCA for 14 years. His character trait is loyalty, using difficult times to demonstrate my commitment to God and to those whom he has called me to serve. Griffin is always there for his family, his friends, and his classmates, no matter the situation. Despite his hard football exterior, he is a caring and considerate young man. Griffin will attend Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University and study mechanical engineering. Griffin Daniel Horn. Rachel Ann King. Rachel Ann King. Rachel is the daughter of Rick and Ellen King. She has attended CFCA for 11 years. Her character trait is initiative, recognizing and doing what needs to be done before I am asked to do it. Rachel's capability to be there to help when it is needed is superhero level. Her desire to serve others and lend a hand makes her stand out in a crowd. Upon graduating, Rachel will attend Sam Houston State University and study animal science. Rachel Ann King. Adam Lane Matthews. Adam Lane Matthews. Adam is the son of Will and Susan Matthews. He has attended CFCA for 4.5 years. Adam has been named CFCA's 2020 salutatorian. His character trait is wisdom, seeing and responding to life situations from God's frame of reference. Adam is a young man of thoughtfulness and clear values. He works hard to stand for what is right and be the kind of person that God desires for him to be. Upon graduating, Adam will attend Florida State University and study mechanical engineering. Adam Lane Matthews. Gabrielle Mosilin Oliveira. Gabrielle Mosilin Oliveira. Mochi is the son of Patricia Mosilin. He has attended CFCA for 1 year. His character trait is persuasiveness, guiding vital mental truths around another's mental roadblocks. Mochi's presence in a room doesn't go unnoticed. His persistence helps others to see his perspective, and he is a friend to everyone. Mochi plans to attend University of South Florida and study civil engineering. Gabrielle Mosilin Oliveira. Haley Simone Morgan. Haley Simone Morgan. Haley is the daughter of Everard and Sherelle Morgan. She has attended CFCA for 13 years and is an Old Eagle recipient. Her character trait is creativity, approaching a need, a task, an idea from a new perspective. Haley has the gift to see each situation that comes her way in a new light and puts a lot of thought and action into her responses. Haley plans to attend Stetson University and study communication and media studies. Haley Simone Morgan. Brandon Lam Wing. Brandon Lam Nguyen. Brandon is the son of Duc Nguyen and Tuyet Nguyen. He has attended CFCA for 4 years. Brandon has been named CFCA's 2020 valedictorian. His character trait is diligence, visualizing each task as a special assignment from the Lord and using all my energies to accomplish it. Brandon desires to do all that he does with excellence. His drive to pursue and complete his dreams helps him to overcome any challenges that may come his way. Upon graduation, Brandon plans to study at the University of Central Florida and study computer engineering. Brandon Lam Nguyen. Ariel Madeline Obricki. Ariel Madeline Obricki. Ariel is the daughter of John and Susan Obricki. She has attended CFCA for 6 years. Her character trait is hospitality, cheerfully sharing food, shelter, and spiritual refreshment with those God brings into my life. Ariel's openness to anyone that comes into her path reveals her ability to put trust in others regardless of their background or reputation. Upon graduation, Ariel will attend Valencia College. Ariel Madeline Obricki. Mm-hmm. Julie Ferreira Oliveira. Julie Ferreira Oliveira. Julie is the daughter of Fabiano and Shelly Oliveira. She has attended CFCA for 7 years. Her character trait is responsibility, knowing and doing what both God and others are expecting of me. Julie's response to any task is to do the right thing and to make sure that the job is done on time and accurately. Her ability to rise to the level of expectations will help her succeed in any field she desires to study or follow. Upon graduation, Julie will attend the University of South Florida and study pre-medicine. Julie Ferreira Oliveira. Juwan Andre Priester. Juwan Andre Priester. Juwan is the son of Jerome Priester and Albrenna Hughes. He has attended CFCA for 2 years. His character trait is determination, purposing to accomplish God's goals in God's time, regardless of the opposition. Juwan is a young man who has the drive to succeed in life, whether it be in sports, in the classroom, or to be a great friend to others. He brings it with a smile. Juwan will attend Houghton College and study business management. Juwan Andre Priester. Eric Oyani Rodriguez. Eric Oyani Rodriguez. Oyani is the son of Eric Rodriguez and Evelyn Gonzalez. He has attended CFCA for 4 years. His character trait is flexibility, not setting my affections on ideas or plans which could be changed by God or others. Oyani's fun-loving spirit shows how much he is willing to go with the flow of any conversation, friendship, or situation that life throws at him. His smile is contagious and always lights up the room, even if you might be a little upset with him. Oyani will attend State University of New York, Morrisville, and study political science. Eric Oyani Rodriguez. Joshua Sanjay Sayodat. Joshua Sanjay Siodat. Josh is the son of Amrita Buddha. He has attended CFCA for 4 years. His character trait is generosity, realizing that all I have belongs to God and using it for his purpose. Josh loves to have a good time with his friends. He will reach outside of his close friend circle to share in the joy of a good time or food with anyone he meets. Josh will attend Seminole State College and study mechanical engineering and computer science. Joshua Sanjay Siodat. Nicholas Campos Silva. Unfortunately, Nick is unable to be with us today. We will miss you, and we hope you are doing well in Brazil. Nick is the son of Luis and Luciana Silva. He has attended CFCA for 1 year. His character trait is sincerity, eagerness to do what is right with transparent motives. Nick is a young man who asks great questions. Nick desires to think through new information and make choices based on what he believes to be best. Upon graduating, Nick plans to attend Miami Prep. Nicholas Campos Silva. Parker Andrew Theobald. Parker Andrew Theobald. Parker is the son of David and Pam Theobald. He has attended CFCA for 18 years and is an Old Eagle recipient and second generation Eagle. His character trait is enthusiasm, expressing with my spirit the joy of my soul. Parker loves life and loves to share it with his friends and family. He can find enjoyment in even the most difficult situations and helps others to do so as well. Parker plans to attend the University of Central Florida and study sports management. Parker Andrew Theobald. Jalen Todd Underwood. Jalen Todd Underwood. Jalen is the son of Melissa Underwood. He has attended CFCA for 14 years and is an Old Eagle recipient. His character trait is security, structuring my life around that which is eternal and cannot be destroyed or taken away. Jalen knows who he is and what he wants. His relationship with his mom and family show that he values hard work and close relationships. His ability to make much from little is a testament to his upbringing and his desire to do great things. Upon graduation, Jalen will attend the College of Central Florida and study criminal justice. Jalen Todd Underwood. Bradley Abraham Van Dam. Bradley Abraham Van Dam. Bradley is the son of Joseph and Diane Van Dam. He has attended CFCA for 16 years and is an Old Eagle recipient. His character trait is joyfulness, the spontaneous enthusiasm of my spirit when my soul is in fellowship with the Lord. Bradley's smile is contagious, and he never misses a chance to have a laugh with his classmates. He never takes himself too seriously and can distract even the best of teachers from their planned activity of the day. Upon graduation, Bradley will attend Valencia College and study general engineering. Bradley Abraham Van Dam. Joshua Earl Burgell. Joshua Earl Burgell. Josh is the son of Stephen Burgell and Sheila Jones. He has attended CFCA for 7 years. His character trait is self-control, instant obedience to the initial prompting of God's Spirit. Josh values hard work and loyal friends. His relationship with his mother and family also show how much of a teddy bear he can be, despite his football physique. Upon graduation, Josh will attend Florida Atlantic University and study mechanical engineering. Joshua Earl Virgil. Ha Mifa Vo. Ha Mifa Vo. Mifa is the daughter of Tung Va and Mai Nguyen. She has attended CFCA for 3 years. Her character trait is tolerance, acceptance of others as unique expressions of specific character qualities in varying degrees of maturity. Mifa reveals her true colors every day, whether in the hallways, talking to the new students, or hanging out with her classmates that she doesn't normally hang out with. She has an affinity to welcome anyone and to make them feel like they belong. Upon graduation, Mifa will attend Valencia College and study pre-medicine. Ha Mifa Vo.
At this time, we will commission our seniors who've just graduated. At this time, I would like to invite the class president and the vice president of the class of 2020 to come to the stage. Seniors, please stand at your seats. Today, I'm humbled and honored to officially commission you. The greatest commission ever recorded is in Matthew 28, when Christ commissioned his disciples to go and make disciples by sharing the good news. Paul commissioned Timothy in 2 Timothy chapter 4 to lead. And now, seniors, it's your time and your place to lead, so seize it now. As headmaster of Central Florida Christian Academy, I officially commission you to go into all the world and make disciples for him. Seize this day and the coming days for Christ to work through you. Bradley and Miles, I'm going to light your candle. The candle is symbolic of Jesus, the light of the world. By lighting this candle, we are symbolizing your commissioning and the commissioning of the class of 2020 to be the light of the world. The challenge to each of you is to carry the light of Jesus into the dark world. Seniors, let this light represent the hope of Christ. And our challenge is to take this hope to a lost and confused world who needs the hope of Jesus Christ. Seniors, please turn your tassel. At this time, graduates, we want to help you commission the junior class at this moment. So we'd like to invite the class president and vice president of the class of 2021 to the stage. Graduates, please light the candles of the juniors at this time. Graduates, congratulations. You may blow out your candles at this time.
Juniors, we've just commissioned our graduates, so now I want to challenge you in the class of 2021 to take the torch they've passed to you and to run the course set before you. I challenge you to lead as seniors next year in a role of Christ-like leadership, one in which you humbly serve and lead by your example. I ask that you consider very carefully and prayerfully the leadership that is being passed on to you and how you will honor our Lord. I, along with our faculty and staff, encourage you and challenge you with the words of the Apostle Paul from Philippians 1, 9 through 11. And this I pray, that your love may abound still more and more in knowledge and all discernment, that you may approve things that are excellent, that you may be sincere and without offense till the day of Christ, being filled with the fruits of righteousness, which are Jesus Christ, to the glory and praise of God. Juniors, soon to be seniors, I thank you for your commitment to CFCA, and I now commission you and your class to lead the student body for the 2021 school year. Seniors, you may blow out your candle and be seated. Graduates, you may be seated.
Danis once said, the hardest choices require the strongest wills.
But remember, in the words of Uncle Ben from Spider-Man, with great power comes great responsibility.
Congratulations, seniors!
We love you!
Peace out.
Doesn't matter what the press says. Doesn't matter what the politicians or the mobs say. Doesn't matter if the whole country decides that something wrong is something right. This nation was founded on one principle above all else. The requirement that we stand up for what we believe, no matter the odds or the consequences. When the mob and the press and the whole world tell you to move, your job is to plant yourself like a tree beside the river of truth and tell the whole world, no, you move. Praying for you, seniors. Congratulations.
Hey, congratulations, class of 2020. I have watched the close bond you guys have had toward each other, and I've taught almost all of you for many years, but congratulations. Stay in God's word. That's going to get you through this life.
Hey, class of 2020, you guys finally made it. Have a good summer. Bye.
Hey, seniors, I cut my hair for this, but I forgot to dress up. It's been awesome getting to know you guys over the past 2 years. Wish you all of the luck in the future, and know I will continue to keep you in my prayers.
Class of 2020, I am so glad to have taught most of you for a really long time, and even those of you who I just had for a year. I'm proud of you and all of your accomplishments. Remember one thing from Mrs. LaViolette. You are way more capable than you think you are sometimes, and so just trust that you can do it, and trust the Lord to be your help as you go along in life. I love you. I'll miss you. Come back and see me sometime.
Hey, seniors, congratulations on a great year. We love you, we will miss you, and we can't wait to hear all of the amazing things that you're going to go off and do. Congratulations.
Hey, seniors, this year has been proof that life does not always go the way we planned. And I want you to keep in mind that in our life, it's far more about the journey than the destination. God wants to change you, refine you, form you into exactly who he's made you to be in all the difficulties of life. So surrender yourself to him, your hopes, your plans, your dreams. He loves you perfectly. He will not leave you astray, and he will never leave you. You are deeply, deeply loved.
Tony Stark said, part of the journey is the end. Your journey as a child is ending, but your journey as an adult is just now beginning. You are now headed off to college, work, and life. So my last two words of advice to you are, anything worthwhile is never going to be easy. And lastly, you can work hard, but if you don't work smart, you'll work for the rest of your life. Congratulations, seniors. We love you and we'll miss you.
Seniors, congratulations. As you guys go out into the real world, I'd like to leave you with the words of Jesus, who said, in the world, you will have trouble, but take heart, for I have overcome the world. Amen.
Class of 2020, congratulations. What a road you've taken to get to this moment. But I hope and pray that whatever road you take next, you invite Jesus to go with you. Go get them, guys.
Good evening, graduates. Just would like to say a short message as you leave here. You are taking so many memories with you, and not just the memories you made over the years, but also the love and prayers of your teachers and the staff here. I just want you also to take a look next to you and beside you, and you'll see the love of your family and friends and those that are going through life with you. May God's grace continue to follow you wherever you may go and follow your passions and your dreams. We're going to miss you, and go Eagles!
Hey, seniors, class of 2020, it's finally here. You guys are graduating, and I am so incredibly proud of you. Please listen to him, and he will take you through the journey of a lifetime. Congratulations, and I'm so proud of you.
To the class of 2020, I just want to say thank you for being the leaders on campus. I know that none of you took my class, but it was a joy to watch you in the hallways, goofing off and making jokes. Thank you, Larry, my intern, who did a phenomenal job walking alongside of me. So respectful. I wish nothing but the best for you. And I leave all of you a verse in Proverbs 19, 20 through 21. It says, "Listen to the advice and accept instruction, that you may gain wisdom in the future. Many are the plans in the mind of man, but it is the purpose of the Lord that will stand."
Seniors, I cannot believe tonight is actually here. I am so proud of the young women and the young men that you've all become. I am so proud of each one of you and what you're about to go do. Go out into the world and be a light. I love you. We're always here for you. And just remember, once an eagle, always an eagle.
We love you, 3,000.
Will the class of 2020 please rise? You may begin the celebration by carefully tossing your cap. Tonight, I have the honor of closing our ceremony in prayer. I would like to say congratulations to the class of 2020. Mrs. Matthews and I have enjoyed being your sponsors. Will everyone please stand? Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, first of all, we thank you for sending your Son down to this broken earth, dying on a cross, and raising from the dead so we could live for you. We thank you for bringing us here tonight, even in the midst of all this uncertainty. We thank you for allowing us to gather and celebrate the accomplishments of these students. We thank you for giving CFCA these students, whether it be for 1 year, or in some cases up to 18 years. We thank you for blessing us as parents, for the amazing and sometimes overwhelming task of raising these young men and women to walk in the light of your word and to follow your footsteps, even though we selfishly wanted them to follow in our own. We realize that we cannot thank you enough for the gift that you have given us with these students. May these students accept the promise that you are always for them and not against them, even in the middle of the chaos that life can present. May these students understand the promise that you will never leave them nor forsake them. May these students believe that you died for them and live for them yesterday, today, and forever. Protect these students with your mighty hand as they go out into the world to learn, make mistakes, enjoy life, and succeed. But most of all, go with them as they make mistakes, seek forgiveness, read your word, talk to you daily, trust even in the hard times, and hopefully surrender to your plan for their life. As Numbers 6, 24 through 26 says, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace. We pray that you will bless and keep these students and to show them grace and give them peace in all they do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Please be seated. Congratulations again to the class of 2020. It's been a very special evening, and we would like to continue our celebration. Please join us in the parking lot for our reception, but please continue social distancing. Please visit each car, each senior's car, and extend a special thank you and congratulations to them. Please remain seated, and I will dismiss each senior and their family, and please exit the same way that you entered. Larry Forrest, Brandon Wynn, Bradley Van Dam, Caillou, and Gabriel Mosley. Oyani Rodriguez, Rachel King, Haley Morgan, Juwan Priester, Mikhail Hernandez, and Adam Matthews. Bo, Jared Furtado, Jalen Underwood, Miles Bruton, Ariel Obricki, Griffin Horn. Finally, Mifa Vogt, Joshua Virgil, Lisa Holly, Gabby Costa, Josh Ciudad, and Julie Olivero.